Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In today's session, we are going to discuss chapter number 2, Microorganisms, Friends and Foe. Subject Science, Standard 8. You have seen several kinds of the plants and animals around you. However, there are other living organisms around us as well, which cannot be seen without unaided eyes. We cannot see them with naked eyes. These organisms are known as microorganisms or microbes. In this topic, we are going to study about these microorganisms. Some of the microorganisms are very helpful to us, while some are harmful. So, we will discuss about them in detail. Today, we will discuss about the harmful microorganisms as well as introduction to the microorganisms. So let's start.
Organisms that are so small that they cannot be seen by unaided eyes, they can only be seen through a microscope, are called microorganisms or microbes. Even if you look at the name carefully, it is made up of two words, micro and organisms. Micro, it means very small, and organisms, it means a living thing. So, whichever are very small creatures, they are very small in size that we cannot see them without unaided eyes, and we need microscope to observe them. These kind of the organisms are known as microorganisms. Some of these, such as fungus that grow on bread, can be seen with a magnifying glass. Other cannot be seen without the help of a microscope. If you keep bread or chapati for a longer period of time in an airtight container, you may find some white or colorful patches on them. These are fungus. Fungus are also a kind of the microorganism. We can see them with the help of magnifying glass. Microorganisms are classified into four major groups: bacteria, algae, protozoa, fungi, and viruses.
Microorganisms may be single-celled like bacteria, or it can be multicellular such as algae and fungi. They can survive under all type of environment, ranging from ice-cold climate to hot spring and desert to marshlands.
Some of the bacteria can grow in the very hot climatic condition, while some can survive in the ice as well.
They are found inside the bodies of animals, including humans. There are certain bacteria in our body which helps in the process of the digestion.
Some microorganisms grow on other organisms, while some exist freely. Microorganisms like amoeba can live alone, while fungi and bacteria may live in colonies. Here you can see some pictures of the various microorganisms. First two are the picture of bacteria. First one is the spiral bacteria and another one is the rod-shaped bacteria. Next one is the picture of algae. Spirogyra is an example of algae. It can prepare its own food because it contains chlorophyll, so it can perform the process of photosynthesis like plants. Amoeba and paramecium are examples of protozoa. Both are single cellular organisms. They can survive and do each and every process within a single cell only. That's why they are known as single cellular organisms. Bread mold, penicillin, aspergillus, these are examples of the fungi. Now let's discuss about the viruses. Viruses reproduce only inside the cell of the host organism. It means they cannot survive independently. They take nutrients directly from the host. Most of the viruses cannot survive in the atmosphere. They need some medium to transfer from one place to another. Common ailments like cold, influenza, which is also known as flu, and most coughs are caused by viruses. Even serious diseases
like polio and chicken pox are also caused by viruses. Diseases like dysentery and malaria are caused by protozoa, while typhoid and tuberculosis are bacterial diseases. Here we have discussed how they are harmful to us because they are causing variety of diseases in our body. As we have seen, some of the microorganisms can cause disease in human beings and plants as well as in animals. Such disease causing microorganisms are known as pathogens. Some microorganisms spoil food, clothing and leather. You may have observed colorful patches on the leather material or clothes during rainy season because moisture content is more in rainy season and fungus can grow faster in the rainy season. These white patches are indication of the development of fungus. Even if you sprinkle some water on the bread or chapati, and if you keep in airtight container, and if you observe it after few days, then you may observe colorful patches on the bread or chapati. These are the fungus. Pathogens enter our body through the air we breathe, the water we drink, or the food that we eat. They can also get transmitted by direct contact with an infected person or carried through an animal. Such kind of the disease are known as communicable disease. Cholera, common cold, chickenpox, tuberculosis are communicable disease. When a person suffering from common cold sneeze, fine droplets of the moisture carrying thousands of the virus are spreaded in the air, and these virus may enter in the body of a healthy person while breathing, and it cause infection to the person. There are some insects and animals which act as carriers of disease-causing microbes. Housefly is one such carrier. The flies sit on the garbage and animal excreta. Pathogens stick to their bodies. When these flies sit on the uncovered food, they may transfer the pathogens. Whoever eats the contaminated food is likely to get sick. So, we always advise to keep the food covered. We should never eat uncovered food items. Female Anopheles mosquito, which carries the parasite of the malaria. Mosquitoes are parasite because they are dependent on the host for the nutrients. They get nutrients directly. So whenever they bite, they carry the parasite of malaria. Those are Plasmodium. And those plasmodiums enter in our body and cause malaria. Female Aedes mosquito act as carrier of dengue virus. All mosquitoes breed in water. Hence, one should not let water collect anywhere in coolers, tires, flower pot, etc. Microorganisms that grow on our food sometimes produce toxic substances. These make the food poisonous, causing serious illness and even death. So, it is very important that we preserve food to prevent it from being spoiled. We will discuss about the various methods of the food preservation in next session. We have discussed how microorganisms are harmful to the human beings. Now, let's discuss how they cause disease in animals and plants. Anthrax is a dangerous human and cattle disease caused by a bacterium. Foot and mouth disease of cattle is caused by a virus. Several microorganisms cause diseases in plants like wheat, rice, potato, sugarcane, orange, apple, etc. These diseases reduce the yield of crops. They can be controlled by certain chemicals which kill the microbes. Such chemicals are known as pesticides. Here, one table is given about the plant disease, due to which microorganisms they are caused and their mode of transmission. First one is citrus canker,
which is caused by bacteria, and this kind of the bacteria are spread through air. Another one is rust of wheat, which is caused by fungi, and this kind of the fungi can be spread by air as well as seeds. And last one is yellow vein mosaic of bhindi, or we can say okra. They are caused by virus, and their mode of transmission is insect.
We have discussed how microorganisms are harmful to us. Let's discuss about some friendly microorganisms. The organic waste such as vegetable pills, remains of animals, fish, etc. are broken down into the harmless and suitable substance by bacteria. Farmers used to collect waste of the plants and they used to keep it in a pit and leave it for some time. They are converted into the manure by bacteria. So such waste are cleaned and they can be converted into some useful substances by bacteria. They clean up the environment and they help the farmers. Now these manure are used in the field again, and the nutrients released in the process could be used by the plants. In agriculture, rhizobium bacteria are used to increase the soil fertility by fixing the nitrogen. Rhizobium bacteria survive in the roots of the leguminous plants such as mung, various type of the lectins, etc. They convert atmospheric nitrogen into the soluble nitrogen, and plant can absorb it and utilize it to make proteins. Let's discuss about some microorganisms in our daily life. The bacterium Lactobacillus promote the formation of the curd. With the help of this Lactobacillus, milk is converted into the curd. If such bacteria are not present, then it is not possible to convert milk into curd. Lactobacillus multiplies in milk and convert it into curd. Bacteria are also involved to prepare cheese, pickle, and many other food items as well. Yeast reproduces rapidly and produces carbon dioxide during the respiration. Bubbles of the gas fill the dough and increase its volume. Yeast in baking industry for making breads, pastries, and cakes are widely used. You may have observed that your mother used curd in the batter of idli and dokla. Because of the curd, fermentation takes place and they become spongy. Base of the pizza, breads, pastries, cakes are spongy just because of the yeast. Microorganisms are used for the large-scale production of alcohol, wine, acetic acid, which is also known as vinegar. Yeast is used for commercial production of the alcohol and wine. Yeast is grown on natural sugars present in the grains like barley, wheat, rice, and crushed fruit juices. The process of conversion of sugar into alcohol is known as fermentation. To understand how alcohol is prepared, you can perform an activity. Take 500 ml water, add 2 tablespoons sugar in it and stir it well. Then add 1/2 spoon of the yeast. Leave it for 4 to 5 days and cover it in a warm place. Now, after 4-5 days, you smell it. You may feel that smell is little bit different, and it is the smell of alcohol and carbon dioxide gas would be released from it. This is how alcohol is prepared from various juices and grains. In the last session, we have discussed many diseases are caused because of the microorganisms, but microorganisms are helpful in the field of medical also. They can protect us from variety of disease. Medicines kill or stop the growth of disease causing microorganisms are called antibiotics, and antibiotics are being produced from bacteria and fungi. Nowadays, number of antibiotics are being produced from bacteria and fungi. Streptomycin, tetramycin,
are example of such famous antibiotics, which are made from fungi and bacteria. Such kind of the antibiotics are used to cure a variety of diseases. Antibiotics are even mixed with the feed of livestock and poultry to check microbial infection in animals. They are also used to control many plant diseases. Alexander Fleming was working on a culture of disease. From the module, he developed penicillin. So we can say penicillin was discovered by Alexander Fleming. Doctor used to prescribe variety of the antibiotics as per the disease. We should take antibiotics on the advice of qualified doctor only, and even we should complete the course of the prescription given by the doctor. If we take medicines without any prescription, then it may affect us adversely. Antibiotics are not effective against the cold and flu as they are caused by viruses. Antibiotics can work against fungus and bacteria only. You may have heard about vaccine. When a disease carrying microbe enters in our body, the body produces antibodies to fight the invader. If dead or weakened microbes are introduced in a healthy body, the body fights and kills them by producing suitable antibodies. The antibodies remain in the body and we are protected from the disease causing microbes forever. This is how a vaccine works. Several diseases including cholera, tuberculosis, smallpox and hepatitis can be prevented by vaccination. You may have seen posters or you may have seen advertisement on the TV and newspaper regarding the protection of children against polio under the Pulse Polio program. Pulse drops are given to children are actually a vaccine. Here, picture of the Edward Jenner is given. He discovered the vaccine for smallpox in 1798. Microorganisms are also used for the food preservation. As we have discussed in last session, some of the microorganisms spoil our food, but some can help in preservation of the food. First one is the chemical method. Salt and edible oils are common preservative. We add salt or acid preservatives to pickles to prevent the attack of microbes. Sodium benzoate and sodium metabisulfite are common preservatives. They are used to store food items for the longer period of time. Preservation can also be done by common salt. Meat and fishes are covered with dry salt to check the growth of bacteria. Salting is also used to preserve amla, raw mangoes, tamarind, etc. Preservation can be done by sugar. Jams, jellies, squashes are preserved by sugar. Sugar reduces the moisture content, so they can be stored for the longer period of time. Next is preservation by oil and vinegar. Vegetables, fruits, fish and meat are often preserved by oil and vinegar. You may have observed that your mother used to boil milk to store it for longer period of the time, because boiling kills many microorganisms. Low temperature inhibits the growth of microbes. That's why we used to keep cooked food and vegetables in the refrigerator to keep them fresh. The milk is heated at about 70 degrees Celsius for 15 to 30 seconds and then suddenly chilled and stored. This process was discovered by Louis Pasteur. That's why this process is known as pasteurization. Airtight packets are used to prevent the attack of microbes. Most of the food items are stored in the airtight packets. We can consume pasteurized milk directly because microorganisms are not present in it. Now let's discuss about nitrogen cycle. Nitrogen gets fixed through the action of lightning. As we know, atmosphere has almost 78% nitrogen gas, but this nitrogen gas cannot be utilized by plants directly.
Now it's time to note down your homework. Your today's homework is, you have to write down exercise in your notebook. Hope you have enjoyed this session. Bye-bye. Take care. Stay at home. Stay safe.
Certain bacteria and blue-green algae present in the soil fix this nitrogen. It is used for the synthesis of plant proteins. Animals feeding on the plants get these proteins and other nitrogen compounds. As human beings and other animals eat such plants, we obtain protein from such plants. Whenever dead and decay compounds are found on the land, bacteria and fungi present in the soil convert this complex substance into the simpler one, and they convert this nitrogenous waste into the nitrogenous compound. So we can say that these kind of the nitrogenous compounds are back to the soil, and even some bacteria can convert some part of this nitrogenous compound into the nitrogen gases, which goes back into the atmosphere. So the balance can be maintained. Here you can see the picture of nitrogen cycle. Uppermost is the atmospheric nitrogen. It is converted into the soluble form by nitrogen fixing bacteria and blue-green algae. Bacteria in turn fix nitrogen into the nitrogenous compound, and this compound of the nitrogen is added into the soil, and this nitrogen compound is again absorbed by the plants. Some animals eat these plants and get this nitrogen in their body, and we can prepare protein in our body. Whenever death of an animal occurs or whenever a plant is dead, nitrogenous waste from the excretion and the death is again converted into the compound of the nitrogen. Some of the bacteria are present in the atmosphere, which can convert this nitrogenous compound into the nitrogen gas. And this nitrogen gas goes back into the atmosphere. Whenever lightning occurs, it also breaks down the substances of the nitrogen gas present in the atmosphere and convert it into the soluble form. This was all about the usefulness of the microorganisms. We can say that they are friend as well as foe, because they are helpful to us, but some kind of the microorganisms are harmful as well. If you have really enjoyed this session, please like the video. Don't forget to share it with your friends. If you have not subscribed my channel yet, please subscribe it right now by pressing the bell icon on the right hand side. Thank you.